That's it right now, T-Nail.
What's up, YouTube? This is CrownSpectro back here with another video for you guys, man. And today we're going to talk about Killzone. Now, personally, I never played Killzone. Actually, now I think about it, it came with my PS4 system. Man, that was a long time ago. That was like 2014. Talk about time flies, right? But anyways, yeah, I got it when I first got my PS4. And I was so, I remember it clearly because I was disappointed because I didn't pre-order my PS4 like I was constantly told to do so, but I didn't. So when I went to go get PS4, they were sold out. So I had to wait until they restocked it, and I woke up like so early in the morning to go get it. I can't even remember who took me to go get it. I know I think my brother or somebody took me to go get the PS4 early in the morning. Got a PS4, and I think during that time you could choose what game, or I don't think I chose a game, I think it just came with it. And Killzone Shadowfall came with my PS4, and honestly, I had never played Killzone before. I heard of Killzone, the game on PS3, but I had never played Killzone. First game on PS4, but first game, of course I was going to play it, right? I mean, everybody played their first game on a new console. Like, even if you didn't like that game, even if you absolutely despised that game, you played it simply because it's your first game. And who knows, it might have been your only game at the current time that you had just got your new console. So it was a lot of things to consider and think about. And the fact that I think the only games that were out for the PS4 at the time were Infamous Second Son, Killzone Shadowfall, Knack, and that was it, I believe. I think it was another game, but I just can't seem to remember the other game right now. But as far as I can say about Killzone, I had a lot of fun playing Killzone, you know? I mean, I didn't hate Killzone. I mean, I feel like I was kind of playing, I wouldn't call it Call of Duty, because Killzone felt pretty different from Call of Duty, other than the whole shooter, first-hand shooter, you know, thing. First-hand shooter type, you know, game. And other than that, I think Killzone stands in its own right, and it has its own way. To be honest, I never got into the story of Killzone. I went straight online multiplayer. I didn't even play the story for the game, alright? I'm not going to say a lot to you guys, man. I played the story for, I didn't even play the story for Killzone. So, like I said, I'm not going to lie, I was just playing multiplayer. You know, I just wanted to play a game. I just got a brand new PS4. You know, I've been wanting it. You know, all my friends had a PS4. I had to wait, two weeks before they, like, restocked on PS4s. So, you know, I was already anxious. I was kind of mad because I didn't get a chance to play on the day the PS4 first came out. So, there was a lot of things to consider. A lot of things going through my mind. And I was just really thinking about these things. And, yeah. So, I played Killzone. Had a lot of fun playing Killzone. You know, of course, it was like a day one thing. So, once more games started coming out later on for PS4, of course, I did put down Killzone very quickly. I didn't continue playing Killzone not long. I say maybe like 2 months after PS4 has already been out. So, some more games that came out. Not sure which games came out that I put it in. Might have been 2K, might have been Madden, who knows. Anyways, I do remember that I did quit playing Killzone for a while. And I did come back to Killzone maybe later on that year in 2014, like right before the end of the year of 2014. And, you know, I tried to get back into it, just didn't feel the same. You know, that's like a little thing, you know. When you play day one games with day one games come out with day one consoles. Well, you know, with new consoles and stuff like day one games. And you play those games, and like if you try to come back to those games, you know, you just don't got that day one feeling anymore to them. Like, they feel different. When you play the game, you play day one games like that. Like, they feel different. And I don't know if you guys ever experienced that when you play, like, a game that you ever played on, like, you play a new game that came with your console or something like that. Like, but you try to, like, and let's say, like, 3 months or so later, you decide to come back to that game. And, like, you just don't really feel like you're having the same fun as you did when you first played the game. But maybe that was due to the fact that that was the only game that you had at the moment. So maybe now that you have options, it's kind of like, yeah. So, you know, like I said, Killzone, it was a great game. Dope game. I mean, I wish I would have played the story mode. I kind of do wish I would have played story mode. I feel like I didn't give that a chance. Like, I literally did not touch story mode. I just remember going straight to multiplayer. And ML just wanted to go online and just try to just shoot, start shooting people and playing online and stuff. So, you know, I was really young at the time. Like, I don't know, like, I was like 15, who knows, 15, 14, I can't even remember. I was young. But anyways, it was a lot of things to be going on, and there's a lot of games that were going around, swirling around during the time, and not to mention there was a lot of games that were announcing, you know, since our new console. Of course, tons of new games are being announced. And, you know, I was looking forward to those new games, so, you know, I was biding my time by playing a lot of Killzone. And I played so much Killzone until, yeah, it was until I got Infamous Second Son. That's the game that I ended up putting Killzone down for. And I think Infamous was also a day one game, but I didn't have Infamous and I had Killzone. I didn't get Infamous until, like, later, like, maybe, like, I don't know, 2 or 3 weeks later after I had already played, like, 3 weeks worth of Killzone. So, you know, I got it to Infamous, and that led to me putting down Killzone because I had tons of fun playing Infamous Second Son. So, I was like, you know, I played Infamous on PS3 already, so I had high hopes of playing what to expect from Infamous Second Son. But like I was saying though, anyways though, like I said, what's going on with this Killzone? As far as for a new game or what's going on with Killzone, so far I don't think there's any plans. The company that produced and developed this game is Guerrilla. I think Guerrilla Warfare. I think it's the name of the company. Or Guerrilla Games. One of those two. I know it's Guerrilla something. I can't remember the other name part of it. But anyways, the developer company Sony split ways after Killzone Shadowfall, you know, and basically Sony went and did their own thing, and this developer company also went and did their own thing. You know, there's just, you know, something, these things happen a lot. You know, companies make, you know, big companies and produce companies make games together, and sometimes ideas shift away. And you know, Killzone, when they went, the developers who made Killzone went their own way, decided to work on different projects than what Sony had planned in mind for the PS4, their future games and stuff like that. So they went down different routes. So that was a lot of the reason why that Killzone didn't come back, you know, with another game after Shadowfall. So, but I am indeed hearing rumors that they are indeed working on a new game. Now, that's not to say that it's Killzone, but I hear that this developer company that made Killzone, and I did not know they also made Horizon Zero Dawn. So yeah, that's also a thing. But anyways though, like, they also working on another project that there's rumors going around working on, and they're saying that this is going to be it might be a new online big multiplayer Killzone game. And then do this time, I can another Killzone game, I'm most definitely gonna play it this time. And I'm actually play the story. All right, it'll be dope. I gotta get the story a try. All right, but you know, Killzone, it has potential to come back. You know, maybe Sony and this developer company will see eye to eye once more and make another great Killzone game. So who knows? You guys tell me what you think down in the comment section below about Killzone. I'm CrownSpectro, and I'll see you guys in the next vid. See ya.